Hello, grade 10s. In this video, we're going to be going over functions. We'll be looking at a past paper exam question. I go through all the questions, all the difficult stuff. I give teacher tips along the way. Subscribe for more videos like this. Let's jump right into this one. So as you can see, I have two graphs, two functions, f of x, which is x squared minus 4. From that, you should be able to tell me which of these two functions it is. We'll discuss it now. And g of x. And they give me all this information. You need to read this information. They say that A and B are the x-intercepts of graph F. We can see that. X-intercepts, where it cuts the x-axis. And C and D. So C over here and D, that's the y-intercepts of F and G respectively. So you can see here, C, that is where the one graph cuts the y-axis. D, that's where the other graph cuts the y-axis. K is a point on the straight line. So yes, function g, that is the straight line, the linear function. And it says here that it is a such a way, it's a point in such a way that bk is parallel to the x-axis. I think they actually mean parallel to the y-axis. So if you look at bk like this, it's parallel to the y-axis, it's perpendicular to the x-axis. And then we got F and G intersect, which means they cut at A over here and at E over here. Right, let's jump right into this. These are the questions that we're going to be getting to, so don't go anywhere. As I've already mentioned, the graph F of X is the parabola. How do we know? There's the parabola. It's a happy parabola. It's curving like that. And it's X squared. Positive A value means happy parabola. Check out my videos on parabolas below if you need more of those. And over here it says minus 4. That is actually the y-intercept of the parabola. So we already know that over here, that point over here is going to be negative 4. So right now what I'm doing is I'm looking at the equations that they're giving me, and I'm filling in information that is very obvious, that's jumping out at me. And how do I know that the y-intercept is at negative 4? This is the normal form of the parabola. The c-value is the y-intercept. The c-value is negative 4, y-intercept where the graph cuts the y-axis. Over here, we can see that the straight line is equal to minus x plus 2, first of all, because it's got a negative gradient, which is negative 1. M, the gradient, is negative 1. The line is a decreasing function. So we can, if we go from left to right, to read from left to right, you can see that the line is going down, which means decreasing. Negative gradient, it makes sense. And just like with the parabola, the C value, yeah, in this case, it's plus 2. That's the y-intercept. So where the graph cuts the y-axis, you can see here the green graph, the straight line, is cutting the y-axis at point D. So I know already that D is 2. And I don't know if you noticed, but that's already the answers for our first two questions. 5.1 says, write down the coordinates of C. C is this point over here. As we said, it is the y-intercept of the parabola. So that would be 0 and negative 4. Please note, they say coordinates. Coordinates exist like this. You must say the x and the y. So you can't just say the coordinates of C is negative 4. They won't give you the mark. The C value here, the y-intercept here, this is negative 4. But the coordinate is 0, negative 4. Where x is 0, y is negative 4. The coordinates for D would be 0 and 2. That's over here. Where x is 0, so go down to x. Where x is 0, y is 2. My next question says, determine the length of CD. Now, what do they mean by CD? CD is a straight line connecting points C and D. It's along the y-axis over here. Now, how would we find that length? Well, if this point over here is negative 4, it means that this from here, from O to C, is 4 units. And if this coordinate over here, this one over here, is 2, it means that from O to D is 2 units. So, what's the total length? What is 4 plus 2? 6. 6 units is my answer for the length from C to D. 5.4 says calculate the coordinates of B. Now, as we discussed earlier, B is over here. It is an x-intercept of the parabola. So, it's where the parabola cuts the x-axis. And you need to know that if you're looking for an x-intercept, you must make y 0. It's just a rule. So because we're looking for the x-intercept of the parabola, which is this function over here, we need to, in the place of y over here, put 0 like this. And then we need to solve for x. And as you know, It's x squared, quadratic. We need to factorize this. So this is difference of two squares. So when we factorize it, we get the following. X plus 2, x minus 2. I do have videos on factorizing if you need a refresher. Then you take each bracket, make it equal to 0. So x is negative 2 or x is positive 2. This makes sense that we should get two answers because we've got a quadratic function, we've got a parabola. It cuts the x-axis in two places, over here at b and over here at a. So one of these x values belong to b, the other belongs to a. They asked me for the coordinates of b. Now, b is on the left side here of the y-axis, which means that everything from here, so from the origin over here, this way, these are all going to be negative x values. That means that the x value of b is negative 2. So once again, the coordinate is negative 2, 0, where x is negative 2, y is 0. Remember, we put 0 in the place of y. It's an x-intercept. The x-intercepts, the y is 0. Now, 5.5 is a slightly more challenging question for some people. It says, determine the coordinates of E, a point of intersection of F and G. So they're telling me it's where the two functions cut each other. Now, earlier on, we emphasize how this happens in two places. So the functions cut each other here at A. You can see that the graphs cut, they overlap over there. And at E, we want this coordinate over here. You should actually already be able to tell me one of the coordinates or one of the points of intersection. What would A's coordinate be? Well, A is also an x-intercept of the parabola, and we just worked that out. So A is the other x-intercept, it would be 2 and 0. But we're not looking for A, we want E. Now, how do you find points of intersection in general? What is a point of intersection? So just very quickly, a point of intersection is, it's where the graphs cut each other. And if you take a look at this point over here, it is the coordinate where both graphs have the same x value. So if you go down to the x-axis, this x value is the same for both functions, and the y value is the same for both functions. So basically, one way, or the way that we're going to use to find the point of intersection, is to make the functions equal. The reason we can do that is because of the following. Here's the one equation for the parabola. Here's the equation for the straight line. We just mentioned that because it's a point of intersection, the y values is the same. This y value for the straight line and the parabola is the same at that point. What it means is that this y is the same as this y. Because they have the same y value, it means that we can make this part of the function equal to that part of the function. Another way to think of it is it's basically simultaneous equations. Think of it like this. Y is equal to all of this stuff. Y is equal to all of this stuff. So in the place of y over here, we're going to substitute minus x plus 2. So we're going to replace this y with what y is equal to on this side of the equation, minus x plus 2. I hope that makes sense. If it doesn't, you can just learn it like this. If they say point of intersection, you take whatever y is equal to on this side, so x squared minus 4, and make it equal to whatever y is equal to on this side, like this. You make the y's equal. Then you solve for x. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take everything over. I see an x squared, so I know it's a quadratic equation. I'm going to take everything over to the side and make the equation equal to 0. So what I did here is I took the minus x over, it became positive x. I left the negative 4 on this side, so it stayed negative 4. I took the plus 2 over, it became negative 2. Then you simplify and you get this, which is a trinomial. So you need to do the trinomial, it's equal to 0. There we go, I completed the trinomial. If you need help on trinomials, check out the links in the description box below. Then what you do is you take each bracket, make it equal to 0. So basically, we've got x plus 3 equals 0, which means that x would be negative 3, or x minus 2 equals 0, which means that x would be positive 2. These are the two x values where the graphs intersect. Now, we already spoke about one of these x values. Remember, the graph intercepts at, or intersects at E and A. Remember, A's x value is 2. So that is this point over here where x is 2. That means that this value over here, the x value for point E or coordinate E, if you go down to the x-axis, that x value over here would be negative 3. But I don't just want the x value, I want a coordinate. So what do we do? Well, we're basically solving simultaneously. We just found the x value, I now need to find the y value, because remember, a coordinate has an x and a y. And because this coordinate over here is lying on both graphs, this coordinate e is on both functions, we can take the x value and put it into either of these functions to get the answer. And just to prove that it doesn't matter which one we put it into, I did both. So here I put x is equal to -3 into the parabola, I got 5. I put x is into the straight line, remember it's -3, very important, -, you get 5. Therefore, your coordinate for e is as follows. E, the x value that we found was -3, the y value that we found was 5. 5.6 is an interpretation question, which I know a lot of students do struggle with, so I'll try my best to explain as well as I can. So it says, for which values of x will f of x be less than g of x? Now, you need to understand what they're saying to you. First thing, your answer must be in terms of x values, because remember, the y values, what happens to the y values depends on the x values. The outputs depend on the input. So we always speak, or we're always going to answer in terms of x values. For which values of x? So you must say, your answer will say like x is bigger than 2, or x is between -1 and 2, or whatever. Your answer will be in terms of x. Then what does this mean over here? F of x, basically the y values of the parabola, is less than g of x, the y values of the straight line. So I'm basically asking you, for which values of x is the y values, remember, the y values is all of these values, the y values of the parabola less than the y values of the straight line. Basically, where is the parabola below, less than, below the straight line? That is a simplistic way of thinking about it. So this is just a way to help you think of it. And I highlighted the graphs. So what I want you to realize is, and I'm actually going to not give you the answer straight away because I need you to understand this. So if I choose a random x value, let's choose this one over here. So remember, a was 2, so this one, let's pretend, is 4. It doesn't actually matter what it is. What I want you to do is, if you look at this x value, I want you to draw dotted lines going up and dotted lines going down. When x is 4, the y value of the parabola is up here. It's positive. When x is 4, the y value of the straight line is down here. It's negative. I hope that makes sense. So when x is 4, the parabola is bigger, the y value of the parabola is bigger than the y value of the straight line. Is that what we're looking for in our answer? No, we're looking for where the y value of the parabola is less than the straight line. So let's pick another x value and I'll ask you the question again. What about where x is 0? Here's where x is 0. Go up to the straight line, go down to the parabola. Where x is 0, the y value of the parabola is less than, it's smaller than, the y value of the straight line. That's what I'm looking for here. Where is the y values of the parabola less than the y values of the straight line? Basically, where is the parabola below the straight line? So this is one of the x values where the parabola is below. So is this one. Go down here. Here, the parabola is below the straight line. So is this x value. Go down here. The parabola is below the straight line. And that continues all the way up to over here. Think about it. Even if you choose this x value over here, go up to this graph, keep going up to this graph, the straight line is above the parabola. So this is true from here all the way to here. So basically, for all of these x values, let me use a highlighter to show you, for all of these x values from here all the way to here, this statement is true. And it makes sense if you look at it as well. So from this x value over here, and we know what that x value is, it's the coordinates of intersection here. From there all the way to there, between those two parts of the graph, can you see how the straight line here is above the parabola over here? The parabola is below it. So the parabola is under here, the straight line is above it. And that is only true between those two values of x. So from this coordinate over here, from where x is over here, we worked out what that was. Remember, e was negative 3 to 5. That means that the x value over here is negative 3. And we know that over here at a, the x value is 2. So from this x value to this x value, that is where the statement is true. But it's less than, not equal to. See here, just less than. It's not a less than an equal to sign. So it does not include negative 3 and it does not include negative 2. So how we write this is as follows. X is bigger than negative 3, but X is smaller than 2. So how you read this inequality is as follows. You read it like this. X is bigger than negative 3. How do I know it's bigger than? Because the open mouth of the inequality is facing X. So X is bigger than negative 3. That's true. X is bigger than negative 3. So it's negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0. But X is smaller than 2. The pointy side of the inequality is facing X. So X is smaller than 2. That's true. X is smaller than 2, 2, 1, 0. So basically X is between these two values, but not including them, because that is not an equal to sign. This is another way to write it, from negative 3 to 2, but not including. Remember, the round brackets means not including. You can just say negative 3 to 2. The next question says where f of x multiplied by g of x is bigger than or equal to 0. Very important, it's also equal to. What this is saying is if I take my y values of my parabola and I multiply them, that's what the dot means, multiply them by the y values of my straight line, where, for which values of x is it bigger than or equal to 0? This is a little bit weird to wrap your head around. Let me take a random x value and show you what this means. So where x is 0, here we know x is 0. Do you see that? Let's go down to the parabola. The y value for the parabola is negative. And we go up to the straight line. The y value for the straight line is positive. What is a negative times a positive? A negative times a positive is a negative. So that won't work because a negative is less than 0. But I want to know the places where I multiply these two functions, the y values together, it's bigger than 0. So it won't work where x is 0. Let's try another random value. What about where x is, let's say, maybe 3? So somewhere here. Go down to the straight line. The straight line is negative. Go up to the parabola. The parabola is positive. Again, negative times a positive is equal to a negative. We don't want a negative. We want where the two functions, the y values multiplied together, is bigger than 0. In other words, positive. So far what we have is basically when we look at the x value, so here, when the one function was positive, the y value, the other function was negative, the y value, it didn't work. Same thing here. The one function was positive, the one function was negative. They're basically on opposite ends of the x axis. Positive times a negative is going to give me a negative, and I don't want that. So we're basically looking for parts of the graph or parts of the Cartesian plane where the functions are on the same side of the x-axis. Where is that true? Because why would we want to look for that? Because a positive times a positive is a positive, or a negative times a negative is a positive. So that happens over here. As you can see here, let's choose a random x value once again. Let's choose negative 5, pretend negative 5. Go up to the straight line. The straight line is positive. Go up to the parabola. It'll be somewhere up there. The parabola is positive. Positive times a positive is a positive. So that is true. So basically, it's where both functions are above the x-axis. So this function, the parabola, is above the x-axis till we get there. Then it goes below the x-axis. And this function is basically above the x-axis all over here, and it carries on. So basically, it is true, this statement is true, from where x is negative infinity, all of those x values, up until where x is 2. You might say, but ma'am, the straight line is still above the x-axis all the way till a. Yes, but let's take 1, for example. Again, where x is 1. Let's go up to the straight line. So here, the straight line is positive, great, but go down to the parabola. The parabola is negative. Again, a situation that we don't want. Positive times a negative is a negative. We want a positive. So that won't work. Even over here, go up to the straight line. Straight line's positive, parabola is negative. It only stops being true, or it only works up until this point over here. Because at this point over here, go up to the straight line. The straight line is positive and the parabola is actually at 0. But it's fine because it's equal to 0 as well. So basically it's all of these x values up to coordinate b. And remember, b was negative 2. So far we've got from negative infinity, where x is negative infinity, all the way till where x is 2. But that's not the only part. Now, we already discussed how it's not going to work for all of these x values. It's not going to work. It's not going to work. We discussed for these x values that it's not going to work. However, for this x value over there, where x is equal to 2, it does work. Why? Because where x is 2, the y value for the straight line is 0, and the y value for the parabola is 0. Okay? And that is, we need that in our answer because it's equal to 0. So we're going to include a union. This is basically or, and then we can do a squiggly bracket where x is also 2. I know that answer looks crazy, but that is the correct answer. And I just wanted to show you how we mark this. So we give 1 mark for the first part of the answer, 1 mark for the second part of the answer. The last question is quite a tough one, like a level 4 question. Out of the box, you have to think a little bit. They want the length of AK. Now, we discuss in this question how to calculate vertical lengths and horizontal lengths. So, for example, because we know that D over here is 2 and C over here was negative 4, we were able to calculate this vertical length. And because we know that B over here is negative 2 and A over here is 2, we are able to calculate the horizontal length. So, from B to A, if from B to here is negative 2, that's 2 units, and from 0 to A is also 2 units, then from B to A is 4 units. I hope that makes sense. But this question is asking something a little bit more complicated. It wants me to calculate the length from A to K. So from A to K. So this is not along the y-axis, it's not along the x-axis, it's like this. But if you think about it, does this not form part of a triangle? So take a look. A to K, back down to B, back down to A. And what they do indicate, and what they did tell me in the question, is that this is 90 degrees. So it's a 90 degree triangle. So I could possibly find AK, this length, the length that the question is asking for, using Pythagoras. But if I want to use Pythagoras, I need this length over here, which we actually just discussed. It's 4 units. But we need this length over here. Before we discuss how to get that length over there, BK, I want us to write down that AB is equal to 4 units. So we found that it wasn't given to us, so I want us to write it down. And again, if you missed where I got 4 from, A, the coordinate there is 2, B, the coordinate is negative 2. How many little jumps to get from negative 2 to 2? 4. 4 jumps, okay? 2 to get there and 2 to get there. So we know that. But how do you think I'm going to find BK? I need to find the length BK. How am I going to find that? Well, if I had the coordinate for K, I would be able to find that vertical length over there. If I knew the Y value of K, remember, a coordinate is made up of an X value and a Y value. If I know the Y value, then I will be able to work out how far up we need to go. How am I going to find this y value over here? How am I going to find this coordinate? Well, what we do know is that BK is a straight line. It's parallel to the y-axis, which means it is a straight horizontal line. And that means that B and K have the same x value. So if you had to take a dotted line that goes like this, whatever the x value is of B, it's the same for K. And we know the x value for B. We found it earlier. We know that the x value for B is 2, which means that so far my coordinate for K is 2 and then Y. We don't know what Y is. How would I find the Y value for K? Look at where K is. K is a coordinate on the straight line. So we know the x value, we need to know the y value. We know the input, we need to know the output. Because k is lying on the straight line, what I can do is I can take the input, I can take the x value and put it into the straight line equation because k is lying on the straight line, and I will therefore be able to find the y value. So how it works is as follows. We say, okay, here's the straight line. So we've got g of x is equal to negative x plus 2. Sorry, I made a mistake here. I'm sure you picked up on what I was saying. The x value for b, sorry, is negative 2. A was positive 2. That makes sense. It's negative. It's on that side of the y-axis. So we've got negative 2 is my x. So we take negative 2. We put it in the place of x. So it's minus 2. Plus 2. Minus minus is plus. So it's basically 2 plus 2, which means that my y value is 4. What that means is that my coordinate for k is negative 2 and 4. And remember, we care about the y value because what this means is this is negative 2. It means that this is 4, which means that you need to go up 4 units here. That distance is 4 units. Remember, keep the end in sight. Why do I care what the distance of B to K is? So now I can write BK is 4 units. Why do I care about that distance? Because remember, we are trying to work out the distance of AK, which is in the right angle triangle. It is the hypotenuse. We need to use Pythagoras. So if we know that BA or AB from here to here is 4 units, and B to K is 4 units. How do I find AK? We use Pythagoras. So we're looking for the long side of the triangle. So we say AK squared is equal to 4 squared plus 4 squared. Please remember to write in Pythagoras as your reason. So AK is 5.66 units. They could also ask you things like calculate the area of triangle BAK. You need to be aware of these types of questions that can pop up in this section. I hope that this has been helpful. Please check out the links in the description box below for more videos like this. Subscribe for more videos like this. It means a lot to me when all of you subscribe and you comment below. Can't wait to see you in another video very soon. Bye, everyone.